could we interest you in some chocolate?
Chocolate? Did you say chocolate?
Yes, sir! With or without nuts.
Chocolate? Chocolate! Chocolate!
What's going on, guys? Pegasus from the Wise Fire Alliance. I appreciate you guys for tuning in. We're here today to talk about the rise of Madolche. Yes, the rise of Madolche. It actually has become an interesting mid-range rogue, maybe meta deck. I doubt meta, but I definitely think it's a powerful rogue deck that you may have to pay attention to because it's helping to stick cards to the board with the new playstyle of the deck. The old playstyle being OTK, 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 Levier, bring back. Yeah, sure, you can still do all of that. And I'm sure that somebody will eventually try to evolve the deck back to that. But for right now, there is a new playstyle that covers all the weaknesses of the Madolche archetype. That being that it didn't have a turn one at first. With cards like Madolche Promenade and Madolche Salon coming out in Eternity Code, it definitely makes for a new threat on the horizon in the form of cute little cuddly chocolate. Weird, I don't really get the fetish of creating decks like this, but the artwork is really, really cool. Decks like Madolche. Madolche is one of the coolest archetypes and one of the strangest archetypes of the game. I mean, absolutely strange. Anywho, back to Promenade. Target one face-up card your opponent controls and one Madolche monster you control or in your graveyard. Negate the effects of that opponent's card until the end phase of this turn. I tried to say end of the turn, but end phase of the turn. And if you do, return your monster to the hand, which helps you reload a card. You can also banish it, then target one Madolche XYZ monster you control and attach it to one Madolche monster from your hand, deck, or grave. That is really, really good. The other card, Madolche Salon, during your main phase, you can normal summon one Madolche monster in addition to your normal summoner set, kind of like a Brilliant Fusion. If another Madolche card you control or in your graveyard is added to your hand or shuffled into your main deck by a card effect, which will happen a lot, set one Madolche Speller Trap directly from your deck so you can actually set the Promenade. Really, really interesting. What's interesting about this deck is that alongside the XYZ that already existed, that came out in Dark Neostorm being the teacher, you definitely have a real possibility of a strong contender because this card, the Exceed Teacher, Souffle, she has the ability to DD Crow or remove stuff out of your opponent's graveyard, which is really, really pertinent. The reason why that's pertinent is because Black Dragon is a card. It's because Eldritch is a card. As we peep one of the deck lists that came out over the weekend, the main goal that I see is that it can go first or second, which I feel like all of these decks in this new meta, this new online lockdown coronavirus meta, they all pretty much skipped out on hand traps, except for this deck, which actually did something over the weekend. There was actually, in two different big online tournaments, a lot of Madolche. So that is very, very interesting to see, and it means it has a high conversion rate. But you can clearly see that it has a really, really high ceiling. Now, was it a lucky weekend? Was it a rogue deck with a good matchup? Is it a new meta deck? What do you guys think? You let me know down in the comments. I appreciate you guys for tuning in. This is Pegasus from the Wise Fire Alliance saying I appreciate you guys. Yes, the new mats are in. Make sure you check them out. They will have info on the Wise Fire Alliance's group page, The Owl's Nest. Make sure you go over to Facebook. Join the page, join in on the fun. Hell, friend me on Facebook if you can find me. I'm out. YG, baby!